Hey guys, this is Saurabh Nahari from AllAboutTechnologies, and in this video, I will give you a quick overview and my initial impressions on the Mi Mix 2. So yeah, without wasting any more time, let's begin. Alright, so let's start with looks first, and I must say that it looks beautiful. Almost no bezel on the top, and at the bottom also there is very minimal bezel just to house a camera. By the way, we will talk about this camera in a bit. But yes, overall Xiaomi has proved that it can not only make affordable phones very well, but can also make something innovative and game-changing like Mi Mix. So great job, Xiaomi. Now let me give you an overview. So on the top of the display is the earpiece, which blends with the bezel or frame so well that you can't even see it. Not just that, they have put in an ultrasonic proximity sensor, which means that they can now get rid of the bezel on the top, as the ultrasonic proximity sensor can stay underneath the display, which is awesome. But to house that camera, they had to put a bezel at the bottom, which is one of the three ways to put a camera on the front. Well, that brings me to the question which I wanted to ask you all. Will you prefer this placement over the other two? Let me know that in the comments section. Also consider that with this placement, you will have to rotate your phone every time while taking selfie, else you will get results something like this. Also not to forget, as of yet, you can't use filters and some of the features of Instagram if you rotate your device like this. So keep that thing in mind as well. Anyways, due to the string bezel, Mi Mix is just as big as a normal 5.5 inch device, but has a 5.99 inch display, which is awesome. Not just that, it is very comfortable to hold, although it is slippery because of the ceramic back panel, which will attract a lot of fingerprints. So it's always better to use a case which is included in the box. Now on the rear side is a 12 megapixel camera with f2.0 aperture and 4 axis optical image stabilization, which seems great on paper, but I will have to test it in real life to say if it is good. And yes, I know that it is a direct competitor to OnePlus 5 and dual camera would have been great, but sadly not this time. By the way, do you guys think that OnePlus 5T is real and it's coming anytime soon? Let me know that as well in the comment section. Coming onto the I/O, at the bottom is a speaker grill, primary microphone and a USB Type-C port. No headphone jack is present here, which could be a bummer for a lot of people including me, as I still prefer wired earphones or headphones which has 3.5mm pin. And in the past, I have had bad experience of listening using an included 3.5mm headphone jack to Type-C adapter, so I'm just hoping for the best with the Mi Mix. On the right are the buttons which felt really nice, and on the top is a secondary mic. And on the left is a SIM tray which will accept dual nano SIM cards, and Xiaomi claims that it supports maximum number of network bands, which means that you can travel with it in almost any part of the world without worrying. Lastly, just like any other Xiaomi device, it will run on MIUI 8, which is built on top of Android 7.1. Also not to forget that it comes with top of the line Snapdragon 835 with 6GB of RAM and 128GB of storage, so performance should be amazing over here. Anyways guys, that's pretty much it for this quick hands-on and impressions. If you want me to review this device, let me know that in the comment section. Do give this video a thumbs up. If you're new to the channel, then definitely hit that red subscribe button and click that bell icon so that you don't miss out such amazing videos. Make sure to follow me on all my social media networks. Links will be there in the description box along with the link to purchase this device. That's it guys, this is Saurabh Nahar. Thank you guys for watching, bye.